It's the Rhody Roundup, where we're talking about the hot topics that have been making headlines this week. And joining me this morning is WPRI.com reporter Ted Nisi, our roadshow producer Ashley Erling, and local mom blogger Audrey McClellan. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for being here.
Good morning.
Well,
okay, I know we've all checked our Powerball tickets this week. Mm-hmm. Everybody's here, so I guess we're not the winners. But we had not one, but two big winners this week. You think people are going to be rushing out to buy more Powerball tickets?
It's the best kind of advertising the lottery can buy is to have people winning. And it's actually bailing out the state budget in a way. They've got $17 million in tax revenue just coming in because people are winning tickets. I said if they keep this up, we'll all be fine. The deficit will be gone.
I never play the lottery. Right. I'm just not one of those people that's like a lucky person. Mm-hmm. I feel like I won.
Oh, I know.
I feel like I won.
True.
Having two people, the first one, when Louise just came forward this week, I was just watching that news conference and her coming out. I was like, oh my gosh, this is so great. And then the other one yesterday.
Yeah.
It feels like we're on a winning streak.
It does.
It feels attainable. Like, oh my goodness, this actually could happen to just an average Rhode Islander, and you could be a millionaire overnight.
And doesn't it make it great that, you know, I mean, we heard a lot of rumors before Louise came forward, you know, who could be the winner and everything mm-hmm. else, but doesn't it make it even better that so many people love this family? They're such good people. I think that helps everybody.
You couldn't have picked a more sympathetic person to get it. I mean, this older lady, she was so dignified.
Yeah.
She hit the ticket in her Bible. She's clearly
living
like she's going to take care of her family. I mean, it's just perfect.
It's one of those karma stories.
It
came around.
Yeah.
It went to the right person.
And Rhode Island can kind of use a boost. I mean, it's no secret what the state's gone through the last couple of years.
Yeah.
And it's all of a sudden, like, to have positive headlines about us is kind of wild.
Good news all around.
And now we're sitting on edge waiting for the next person to come forward.
Right.
Hopefully just as nice of a person.
My wife had a ticket. She works up there and bought the ticket. She said we weren't a winner. I double-checked it just to make sure. Okay, next up, Demi Moore's daughter, Scout, who goes to Brown University. She's getting some heat. She had some racy tweets that were out, and everybody's beginning to pick up on the fact that it's her. And she's saying, oh, no, it's just a school project. Are we buying this, and what do we think of the tweets? Because some of them,
Well, I guess it worked because she said it was for a social media project.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So if it was really fake, I guess it worked.
Yeah, I did, yeah.
But you have to be a little suspect. Mm-hmm. You do. You have to, with the way that her family's been lately, maybe she just wanted a way to lash out.
A little attention.
Indirectly, a little attention.
Yeah.
But, you know, maybe, I don't know, we could call up Brown perhaps and see if they had some ongoing project.
It is the kind of thing Brown would do. You can easily imagine having let's test out how social media works. It's probably some sociology class or something. But it is sort of wild to have these people have completely lost any semblance of privacy. People will find, you know, I don't know, how did this get found?
I don't even know.
It was on Ivygate.
But then how did Ivygate find it? Like,
I know.
They probably got a tip. But.
And that's the thing. I think that's the beauty of Twitter, and I'm very immersed in Twitter, and I love Twitter.
Mm-hmm.
So I will say, I mean, the experiment worked. And when you want to get a reaction, you want to get followers, you want to get people to hear something as a soapbox, you put something very shocking out there. And I think, you know, we can all, I was on her Twitter feed checking it out. I mean, it worked.
It does work.
I wanted to see the timeline. I even went to her mother. I even went to Ashton. So if in some way it worked, there was a reaction.
Now, you know, the family's got enough issues as it is, you know, with Demi being in rehab, you know, Ashton doing whatever it is he is. What do you think the parents are saying to her after this? You're thinking they're saying, you know, bad time to be doing this.
I don't know what Bruce thinks because right now he seems like the stable one. It's just funny to me. I wonder what Bruce is thinking this morning.
It's tough.
Let's get him on the phone.
All right, our last topic this morning, we were speaking, you know, talking about Demi Moore. Jessica Simpson took a page from Demi's book, posing nude for a magazine cover while pregnant. Some say it's beautiful, others aren't so sure.
Well, you know, my first thought was there's nothing new under the sun. Like, this, I remember a little bit that the Demi Moore magazine was like a very big deal when it came out. People were talking about
shocking.
It. I can't believe they did it. It was shocking. And now it's like there's nothing new to shock people with. We just redo what shocked people 20 years ago.
Exactly. Right.
And if you look at them side by side, it's actually very interesting. When I first saw the one of Jessica, I was like, oh my gosh, that's a lot of Jessica Simpson. But then when you look at the one of Demi, that's a lot of Demi Moore.
And the times are different, too, even when Demi did it.
Yeah,
too,
and they're really identical photos. It's just interesting to see, and I don't know, I guess it's all right. I wouldn't want to do it.
No,
I think she looks gorgeous. I mean, if I could have the nerve to do that on a magazine cover, I would. Yeah. But, I mean, I have to agree with what Ted said. I mean, there's so much out there now with social media. This is nothing new.
Right. Yeah.
I mean, if anything, I feel like it's just a way to get her again in the spotlight.
A little more attention.
And kind of put her out there.
Right. I should say, I was asked to do it.
I was asked to get pregnant again just for that cover.
But I declined.
I opted back to.
Yeah, no,
sorry,
it's the right thing. Tough. Doesn't fit my career.
Thanks so much, guys, for joining us. And to learn more about the stories we talked about, you can head to our website, WPRI.com.